Now, what is the meaning of chemical effects of electric current? Who is going to tell? Chemical effects of electric current. What is the meaning of chemical effects of electric current? Tell me, what is the meaning of chemical effects of electric current? Are you getting my sound?
Yes.
Define, what is the meaning? What is the meaning of chemical effects of electric current? No idea? No idea? Okay, no problem. So, chemical effects of electric current means whenever electric current is passed through any solution or any substance, there is some chemical change. There is chemical change, and this is called as chemical effects of electric current. So, write down. When current, electricity, when current electricity is passed through a substance, there is the chemical change in the substance taken. Chemical change in the substance taken, or some new substances or substance is obtained. Is that clear? So, is called chemical effects of electric current. Is that clear? So this is the statement or the meaning of chemical effects of electric current. Now I am going to write an example. Shall we now take water? Water, this water is acidic. Acidic means little amount of acid has been added, you know, because acid makes water conductive, or you can say that current cannot be passed into water or pure water. So as a result, we have to mix little amount of acid or base to make water conductive. Is that clear? Now, so this is acidic. So when current is passed, so as a result of this, there is formation of hydrogen gas and there is formation of oxygen gas. So this is called as chemical effects of electric current. Is that clear? This is called as chemical effects of electric current. Electricity is nothing but the flow of electrons or the flow of charge. Flow of electrons or flow of charge is called as electricity. So, electricity is nothing but flow of charges. You know, there is a flow of charge. Flow of charge is called as electricity. Whenever there is no difference in charges, like, you know, I am drawing a cell. So here it is plus, here it is minus. What happens? We say that current flows from positive and goes up to negative. This is the concept. This happens in cell, battery, electric wires, all. This is the, you know, direction of what? Current. Current flows from positive to negative. This is the direction of current. Current always flows from positive to negative because of difference in potential. Here at plus potential is maximum. At plus electrode potential is maximum. At this negative potential is minimum. You know, potential means accumulation of charge or anything. Meaning of potential. Potential is accumulation of charge. No, when there is accumulation of charge, you know, charge is collected together, collection of charges. So it is called as potential. Now this is one aspect. Now other point is, at the negative plate, negative side, here the electron density of electron means the concentration of electron. Electron density is, you know, maximum. Electrons are negatively charged. So here at the plus electron is minimum. What happens? Electrons from negative then flow to positive. Electrons have maximum density at negative, minimum density at positive. As a result, electrons will flow from negative to positive. So what we can say? The direction of flow of electrons and direction of flow of current, they are just opposite. Once again, I'm repeating, though in case of a battery or cell, there are two terminals, positive and negative. So positive has maximum potential. What is potential? Accumulation, collection of charges. Here at minus, potential is minimum. So current flows from positive to negative in a cell or in a battery or in electric supply. Now other aspect is that at the negative plate or negative side of battery or cell, the electron density is maximum. Density means collection of electrons. And at the positive, the electron density is minimum. So when the potential is more here of the electron, so electron will flow from negative to positive. In this, just I have drawn for the simplicity. Actually, it takes place in the same wire. It takes place in a same wire. If we draw a conductor, so like this. This is, you know, wire. So, you know, this is positive, this is negative. So, this is the direction of, you know, current. Current flows from positive to negative. And this is the direction of electrons. Electrons flows from negative to positive. So this is, we are just opposite to each other. And this is the basic idea about the electricity. Now we'll see about the static electricity. Static means fixed. Static means fixed. There is no moment. There is no change in the position. So a static electricity may be defined as a type of electricity when it is confined to a place and it it you know remains at a particular place. So if static electricity may be defined as type of electricity confined or located to a place only. It is confined or located means, or what you can say, when charge or charges are fixed at a place. Charges fixed at a place. Now, very simple experiment. You know, take a comb and very small, you know, pieces of paper, and you know, keep the paper in a bowl or something, you know, at some place safely. Take clean comb and rub with any woolen garment, as you know, or your dry hair. You know, repeat 5 or 6 times like this. Repeat the comb like this, and bring near the pieces of paper. You know what happens? There is a difference in, you know, charges. So they will, the small piece of paper, they will be attracted by the comb. So here we'll take, you know, which are the pieces of paper, you know, paper pieces, and here, you know, we take, you know, a comb. This is comb rub on woolen garment. So what will happen? The paper pieces will be attracted towards the comb. So this is the demonstration. This is the demonstration of static electricity. How static electricity is demonstrated. So this is about the static electricity. Now another example is, you know, we have, you know, this nowadays winter we use, you know, woolen clothes. You might have noticed whenever in night time we take out our sweaters or woolen garments, what happens? We notice, you know, there is the sparkles are produced, and if, you know, lights are off, what happens? We see very small sparks also, because again woolen have some charge, our different cloths inside have different charges, and so what happens, there is the reaction between the, you know, positive and negative, and as a result there is no static electricity. So this is the meaning of electricity of static type. Its position remains same. So this is a static current or static electricity.
The transfer of electron or proton.
Yes. So, yes, very good. Now I'm going to explain about the electric charges. So, you know, you have seen about the static current or static electricity. So when we take out our, you know, woolen garments or rub some plastic material on woolen garment, there's the generation of static electricity. So the question arises, from where these charges are originated. Question is, from where the charges are originated. So actually, answer no is very simple. The charges are originated from the atoms. You know, so charges are originated from atoms. You know, atoms. Every substance is made up of, you know, small particles, and these particles are called as atoms. And you know, atoms are made up of different components. So atoms are made up of very small particles, electrons, protons and neutrons. So atoms are made up of these three types of particles, electrons, protons and neutrons. Now there is exception, only one exception, hydrogen. You know, hydrogen atoms, hydrogen atoms have one electron and one proton, no neutron. This you have to remember. Hydrogen is the only atom having no neutron. Is that clear? Now coming about this, so electrons are the particles which have negative charge. Protons are positively charged, and neutrons have no charge. Neutrons are neutral, as name indicates, neutrons. So neutrons are neutral. Now I'm going to draw a diagram of an atom. How, you know, atoms are like this. So you know, in an atom, there is a central portion. In an atom, there is a central portion, central part, core. Core means central. So this central portion, it is called as nucleus. Nucleus is a central portion of an atom. And you know, around the nucleus, there are circular paths. They are the circular path. These are called as cells or orbits. Again, I'm repeating, atoms are made up of central portion called as nucleus, and around the nucleus there are circular paths. These paths are called as cells or orbits. Now nucleus have proton and neutrons. Nucleus have protons and neutrons. And these, you know, cells have electrons. So what we can say, nucleus is positively charged, and the cells, they have the electrons, they are negatively charged. Actually, electrons keeps on rotating. Write down. Electrons and protons are never at fixed place. Never at fixed place, and always always keeps on moving. Always keeps on moving. So whenever electrons are moving, what will happen? There is always possibility of, you know, scattering. And whenever some different charges are there, so what happens? There is a, you know, deviation. When we strike, while in a static electricity, charge are produced, because when we pull out our sweater, you know, or scarf from our head, or cap from head, you know, the atoms, they have, you know, charged particles, electrons and protons, and when we pull out, they are disturbed. So the charged particles are, you know, very small, and so under the influence of other particles, you know, like atoms, these electrons and protons strikes against each other. They strike against each other and a spark is produced. There's the production of a spark. So a spark is produced, and so this is the origin of charges, and this is the, you know, basic sir, points about the atoms. Is that clear?
Sir, side.
Okay.